Hi everybody, this is Kevin Bailey with DB Services, and today I'm going to show you how to integrate Twilio and FileMaker to give you the ability to send texts to the customers or just the people in your database. You can use this for a lot of different reasons, such as keeping people up to date with maybe appointment reminders or sending out discount codes to people in your database, or just keeping in constant communication by texting the phone numbers that you have stored away. So let's just go ahead and jump into my sample file and we can take a look at how the whole thing works. Now I have it set up here, just four easy steps on getting everything set up before you actually send your text. And the first step here is to sign up or log into your Twilio account. So if you have one, that's great. Otherwise, you can just go ahead and sign up. But I've made it easy for you to just click right here and it'll send you right to their website. Now I'm going to go ahead and just log into my account because I've already set one up for testing purposes. We can just go ahead and log in here. And what it's going to do is throw you here onto your dashboard. Now this is what you'll see when you first sign up for your account. The first thing that you're going to want to handle is making sure that you have a phone number to send your information from. So if you click here on phone numbers, it'll let you go ahead and purchase a phone number. They usually only cost $1 to $2. It's a pretty low cost. That is per month, but overall, not a lot to think about. And I've already done that. This is the phone number that I'll be sending my texts from. So once you have that set up, the only other thing you need to really look at is your account number here and then your auth token, which will appear if you click view. Now I've already set up my sample file to have my auth token in there, but I'll go ahead and just kind of copy this. And if you go ahead and enter that in here and then enter your auth token over here, that's pretty much all the information you have, or all the information that you'll need. So go ahead and just click down the line. And then this last one, it's just making sure that you can authenticate your Twilio account. So it's making sure that your account ID can be found and the auth token is correct. And if both of those things are correct, it'll tell you that the authentication was successful and it'll go ahead and check that box and you can move on to the next part. Now this is pretty much all there is to it. You have your phone number that you're sending your text from, which is your Twilio number. So I'll go ahead and actually copy that real quick. I can take this here and dump that in there. And then I'm going to have this send just straight to my phone. And then you can add whatever you want your text body to be. So this is a test from DB Services. Great. And there's only a couple lines of code that really go into this. Let's go ahead and take a look at these before we send the text itself. If you look at the scripts, there's really only a couple lines that need to be looked at. So all this is really doing is just kind of taking your account, your auth token, all that stuff, and then it's throwing it into a URL. So let's go ahead and look at this. Pretty simple stuff. It just takes your account ID, your auth token, and then makes the URL, tells it that it's going to be sending the message. The important part is here in the curl options that you'll be setting in the next line. And all this is doing is just really setting up what the body is, who the call is coming from, and who the text is being sent to. Very simple. It's all being thrown into an insert from URL script step. And once that URL is called, the text will be sent. So I'm actually going to go ahead and show you my phone, and we'll see the text come straight through. So this is actually my cell phone right now. As soon as I click this send text, there it is. This is a test from DB Services. And that's really all there is to it. It's super simple. It's super flexible, and it really is pretty valuable. There's a lot you can do with this to help make your database just a little more usable. Thanks a lot for watching. On my sample file here, if you go ahead and click the About Information button, you'll be able to see a little bit more about us here at DB Services, and it has all of our contact information right there. So thanks a lot. Thanks for watching.